Joining me is the Nationals leader, David Littleproud, and Keep the Sheep founder, Ben Sutherland. Ben, welcome to Parliament. Thank you for being here, David Littleproud. What sort of impact, if the vote goes ahead tonight in the Parliament to ban live sheep exports, what's the impact on the industry?
Pretty horrendous. You know, there'll be people exiting out of the merino industry, you know, no wool. Obviously, live export will be gone, so those animals will be blocking up all the abattoirs and all the other markets we've got going on. For me personally, it's going to be 30% of my bottom line, which is one truck, one driver. If he has a family, it's his family gone out of the community.
Can you adapt to, say, processed meat, as the government's saying?
In my job, I can't, no. Absolutely not. I cut them live. So the infrastructure and the investment we have in our industry is massive. You know, to put one rig on the road, it's about $1.2 million, brand new. You base that out over 7 years, that's a fair few sheep you've got to cart. But as I say, the bottom line, it doesn't also affect me like that. It affects my sporting club. It affects my local IGA and everything. Like, it's a community-based problem.
David Littleproud, how broad is that sort of impact that Ben's talking about?
Oh, it's huge.
You believe?
And the Western Australian government doesn't support this, and they've estimated over the next 10 years it'll cost Western Australia alone $1 billion. And the government wants to try and compensate with $100 million, $107 million. These people don't want compensation. They want their livelihoods to remain. Because if we do remove ourselves from this, let me tell you, there'll be the perverse and horrific death of millions of sheep from other countries because we've cut and run, because our animal welfare standards won't be maintained.
You've known, though, that the ban was coming. This is something the Labor Party campaigned on.
Well, with all due respect, I don't think they got a mandate for live sheep. I don't think Australians went to the last ballot thinking, I'm going to vote for Anthony Albanese because we're going to ban live sheep. I think it was broader than that. I don't think many Australians even knew that it was an industry, to be candid. This is an ideological view that was about them cutting a deal with animal activist parties to get their preferences. That was what took place at the last election, nothing more than that.
And do you believe that your industry's processes are more humane than what will eventuate under a ban, whereas that Mr. Littleproud says other countries will pick up the slack?
They will pick up the slack. It happens in the moratorium now. You know, if Australia leaves that industry, we're leaving the animal welfare open to everyone else. We are the world leaders, mate. There's no two ways about it. We do what we do and we do it well. So I don't see why they can take something away from us when we're probably the top notch at doing what we do.
And do you fear for the scenario if the ban goes ahead as to the animal treatment elsewhere?
Of course we do. We're stockmen. You know, in my industry, we're not only truck drivers and business owners, we're stock person. You know, we look after the animals. Our heart's involved in it just as much as the farmer. You know, so we don't like to see any of that carry on ourselves. I just really think they need to have a good, long, hard look at it.
Well, it looks like it's the 11th hour, actually, so you're going to have to... If you're going to sway votes, it's got to be now. What are you picking up from the crossbench? And the vote comes at a precarious time for the Labor Party with one of their senators being suspended.
Well, it does, and we're trying to reach Senator Payman to say that we respect the fact she's trying to save Palestine. Well, she can help Palestine stay alive by giving them meat, because Western Australian meat go into the Palestine as we speak now. The Jordanians are sending our live sheep after processing them there in there. That's the only way they can get food into the Palestine area. So Senator Payman has made a very principled position about supporting Palestine. She could support her Western Australian constituents and she could support Palestine by crossing the floor. We're trying to talk to Lydia Thorpe as well about the significant jobs in the Indigenous communities that will be lost. Thousands of jobs will be lost and many of those are Aboriginal. We're just saying this is an opportunity to stay, not cut and run, to do our bit, to get it right, to protect Palestine, to protect the Middle East, give them food security and respect their culture, their cultural belief that they want live sheep. Like, we want to have fresh meat on our shelves, so do they.
Is this something, though, that the industry can't fill the gap elsewhere? I know Ben said that he can't in terms of his facility, but...
Yeah,
can others do it? Because you can process it and sell the processed meat.
No, so the issue with it is it's a very seasonal industry, and so to have a new abattoir to take up that slack, $50 million, you've got to keep it going 365 days a year. You wouldn't have enough throughput, so you're only running it 6 to 9 months. You don't have those costs, you can't keep them going, and you can't bring it back across the Nullarbor. They can't compete. So this folly that we can process them all here, but these countries are proud too because they don't want to be talked down to. What they've said to me when I was the minister was that if you don't send live sheep, we won't take your processed sheep. We'll go to these markets like Sudan, South Africa, and take it from there rather than from Australia, where our animal welfare standards are being used in country in the processing. But the shipment, we are world's best, and you will see a perverse outcome. And Animals Australia, RSPCA, are morally bankrupt. They are valuing the welfare of sheep in Australia over that from another country.
How long have... just, I've got to go to a break in a moment. I just want to give you the final comments before you go, yep. Ben. How long will you have to phase out if that vote does go ahead tonight?
Not long
in favour of the government's plan?
Not long enough. Not, you can't have an investment in infrastructure like we have and expect to change overnight, pretty much, you know. It's just... It's a no for me. There's no transitioning out of what we do, you know. It just can't happen. And our hashtag is keep the sheep.
Keep the sheep, Ben Sutherland. Thanks for your time, David Littleproud, Nationals leader. Appreciate it, gents. Come